Hey guys, it's Osher. Today we are going to play FIFA 17 with Valencia, and we are really doing well in the La Liga this season. We have been really, really good, just like last season, maybe even better than last season. We did start the last season really well. It was not that case. In this season, we did lose the first match against Malaga, but this season has been really good. As you can see in the table, we are currently top of the table with 11 games played, 28 points, and we are really at the top of the things. We are, I don't even think, I didn't see Real Madrid or even Barcelona being close to us. They are struggling down below, but this is just start of the season, only 11 matches into the season, and they are going to be close to us and as the season continues to go on. But currently we are the best defensive team, and we have to keep that in mind, and we have to play in that way. I am going with a strong squad, but we have got a Champions League match in the next match in this episode, and it is going to be our next match, the second match of this episode. They have an opening chance, but it was good blocked properly by Telles, and it has gone out for a corner, but nothing came from that significantly. It was pretty poor corner. Our defender dealt with that pretty easily, and Pere with a good first time shot, and it was a good save from the keeper, and it remains nil-nil, but a good save. I have left the highlight of the shot for you guys to see it, because it was a really good shot and a good save from the keeper, or else it would have been 1-0 for us within the 12th minute of the game. We were really dominant side in this game. We were the better side, and Celta Vigo didn't have that many chances, and Joao Cancelo did come close to scoring a goal. A wonderful goal it would have been from a right back. He does play for right mid for Valencia in real life, but I am not using him at right mid because we have got Santimena. And now this, talking about Santimena, look at that poor touch from Santimena. Really poor touch, and I think if that touch was not that poor, he would have been through on goal, and he could have scored a goal for us. Now they had a chance, but the shot was pretty poor. Santimena has it again, and a tap in for Gabbiadini. Really an easy goal for Gabbiadini to score, and the goalkeeper was not in the correct position at that time, and it was an open net to score in, and he did the rest, and that was pretty easy. Just first touch goal, and really it was a pretty easy finish. And that's his fourth goal of the La Liga season. He hasn't started the season brilliantly, but he is making a comeback to the season. I know in the last season we had played 11 games and he had 11 goals, about that. But he did start the last season pretty nicely, but not this season. We are coming close to scoring our second goal, and we are having so many chances. We have another chance from the same wing as Keita Balde, and he was creating so many chances, but we couldn't take it. We couldn't take any of them. That was pretty poor from us, and we could have done better. Now we have a corner. I don't know what happened there, but couldn't take a shot, I guess, in the corner. But Kovacic's shot was directly at the keeper. He didn't even move there. Now Kovacic is he was tackled by the defender, but it was a brilliant tackle. Now back to Kovacic. Kovacic cuts back in. The defender is standing there, and Kovacic still tries to keep the ball, but has failed. But it was a good defending from Celta Vigo. Now Gudieti gets through from our defender, and he scores for Celta Vigo. The former Man City winger, I guess youngster, has scored for Celta Vigo. I really like him as a player, Gudieti, and I might use him in the near future career modes if this career mode ever finishes, because I have taken long time to finish this career mode, and I promise I will finish it. And I think if we win the Champions League, which is really high doubted, if we are going to win the Champions League in this season, because it is our first season, we don't have that great of a squad. But if we do a treble in this season, this might be the last season of Valencia career mode. And in the background, we have scored the second goal. Santimena doesn't make a mistake this time round. He puts the ball into the back of the net really easily. The goalkeeper should have done better, and I really think the defender also should have done better, because we had a really easy path to go into the back line and into the box. Really poor defending. Kovacic gets an assist. It is 2-1, and we did concede a goal. Would have liked to keep a clean sheet, but really sorry for that, but I would have liked to keep a clean sheet, but we have failed. Hugo Malo with the last cross of the game. That was dealt with pretty easily, and Bender clears it away, and it is going to be the end of the match. We get a 2-1 victory over Celta Vigo. Really a deserved victory. We had so many chances, and we did take them pretty nicely. Not nicely, we were pretty shambolic in front of the goal, but we get a goal. We do get a win, so that is pretty important. The 3 points are important, and as I told you guys before, we are going to play SC Braga in this match. In the next match, and that would be the second match of the episode. So we are currently top of the table. Chelsea are just behind us. There is a points difference between all the four teams. So this win would be really important. I think we would be on 9 points. And if Chelsea and Fenerbahce draw, or even I guess one of them lose or win, we could have a great advantage. So we have a first chance of the game. We have a free kick. Parejo to take this free kick. It was not that poor, but it was straight into the hands of the keeper. Now Parejo had such a that pass was pretty good from Pareo, but Balotelli was forced wide to go away from the goal. But Pareo's shot was really good. It has hit the post and come back. This is the second time we have hit the post in the same episode. The defender makes a mistake, and Rodrigo was pretty lucky, but the shot got deflected off Balotelli and it hit the post for the third time in this episode. Really unlucky. Should have gone into the back of the net, and it would have been 1-0 for us. Now Balotelli has the ball back to him. Does well to get away from the defender. It was a nutmeg, and as you can see it, you can just go back and see it. But our attack did end there, but the nutmeg was not that good, I guess. I guess that was not the important thing. But they have a good cross. That was a good cross, but a good save from Diego Alves. They have another chance into the box. Hassan, and he has scored for them. That is 1-0 for SC Braga. We dominated this match, just like the previous match. But we couldn't do anything about this goal. Poor defending from, I guess, the defender, but should have done better. And we deserve to get a 1-0 lead, but we are not getting that. Instead, they have a 1-0 lead, and that's a good save from the keeper. I don't know why, but they are playing like Barcelona in the second half. They did really well to stop us from scoring. Rodrigo does well to get away from the defender, cuts back in, gives it to Gaia. Gaia with a shot, but has been saved by the keeper again. I am not showing you all the highlights because the video would be almost 15 minutes long. So instead, I am showing you all the important highlights. And Balotelli was under it. It was going straight to Rodrigo, but Balotelli decided, the CPU decided to let's hit the ball with Balotelli. And they come close. They had another chance, but no one was there to put the ball into the back of the net. And we come from straight from the attack back to Gaia. As it Gaia gives it to Bazoya. Bazoya with a shot, and he has scored. What a shot from Bazoya. Really a good goal from Bazoya. I haven't used him that much in this season. He has been not that good this season, but he is improving. He is almost 79 rated, or maybe even 80 rated. I don't remember correctly. But they have the last kick of the game almost, and they have almost scored. So it is going to almost end of the match. We get a 1-1 draw, and we had so many chances, but we couldn't take it. So that's the end of the episode. So thank you for watching, and hit the like button if you have liked the episode. So goodbye.